Companies bad for your company. Bad companies bad for your company. Companies in the ski mask in case you come for me. Got in the ski mask in case you come for me. When I say I got beef, they don't want no beef. When they say they got beef, they don't wanna eat. If he said he want, they don't want no steam. She put it on it. Had a bachelor's degree, PhD while selling spelling. Fix the face and fix the weed. Now working on the self-esteem. Hit a block, yo, this flop. Where you at? Pin it. My new mat location be the flop. On the app.
Any money in company? Nah, babe. I don't need no the company.
You can't hang, baby. We don't want you around here. I'm ice on my neck and it's froze. Santa's reindeer. You got bad. It's the same, bad company, little bro.
Hello again, everybody. It is the coach. You're tuned in to Madden 19 on EA Sports. We are moments away from kickoff, and we've got a good one on tap between the Carolina Panthers and the Houston Texans. With that, let's head over to the Space City of Houston. Standing by at NRG Stadium, here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, thanks, Coach. EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. They do it big here in Houston, and a second ago it was a Texas-sized welcome for their hometown guys. They're fired up and ready to go as they get set to match up with the Carolina Panthers. Brandon Godden and Charles Davis with you from a broadcast perch. And Charles, as we get this thing started, what are you going to be keeping your eye on?
Special teams. Field position is always a big determiner in a ball game. Who sets their offense up for success the best? That team will win the game.
Here's Chandler Catanzaro, ready to get this one started. 22 men ready to do battle. It's time to dance. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So out come the Texans for their opening drive. Leading the charge will be their quarterback, always fun to watch, Deshaun Watson.
Everything you want in a starting quarterback in the NFL, especially in the physical category. If you have the idea that he's one of those rah-rah, spitting fire guys, he's not that at all. But he has a will to win that really the team picks up on, and they can't wait to follow him into victory.
Hell, who waited?
Now a first down throw, Watson. The catch made by DeAndre Hopkins. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards. And we see the emphasis early here. Get your star receiver involved, able to do it successfully.
Not a bad start to begin with, that's for sure. And to me, this play says, our guy is better than your guy's up. Because you know, a player of his stature, he won't just be single covered all game long. He's going to involve multiple people. And right away, they told the other team, guess what? He's just better.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Now a play fake here on first down. And this is caught. A spectacular one-handed grab there. Touchdown, Houston. DeAndre Hopkins, 63 yards. And the Texans have taken the early lead. Well, that's how they envisioned it, get the football to start the game and score.
And I don't know if that was scripted. Was it an audible? Or was it just a play call that they had in their pocket? No matter what, they had the right call on against the right defense, and they end up in the end zone.
Kaimi Fairbairn on for the extra point. Fairbairn good with the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. That drive started on their own 25. Two plays, 75 yards later, into the end zone. Barron now to kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been had he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. So here are the Panthers now for their opening drive. And they'll be led out by their quarterback, none other than Cam Newton.
And when he's at the top of his game, you see that big smile, that's when you know everything is clicking. That means he's accurate throwing the football. They can't get him down in the run game, and his team is having a whole lot of fun, because when they score a touchdown, some fan's going to get lucky and get the game ball.
Now a first down throw for Newton. And this is caught. It's Greg Olsen. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A really good pickup of 28 yards.
It's so important to tackle well against these guys, but you and I both know that's easier said than done when the guy you're trying to tackle looks like this guy.
And it's usually going to take more than one man to get him down, and it did right there. So a first and 10 now in Houston territory at the 47.
Ready, ready.
This is Newton off the play fake to McCaffrey. Flushed out right. And he will find the open man. It's DJ Moore. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone. A very solid gain of 27.
Not only have they completed a couple on this drive, but they peeled off some pretty good chunks of yardage, too.
Absolutely. Great start. Two nice plays in the pass game. Now can they continue to feed off that? The first red zone opportunity for the Panthers thus far. First and 10 right at the 20. From the red zone now, Newton steps away to his left. His throw caught right around the 6. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
His passing's been on point on this drive, hasn't it? Been very accurate, gotten the ball downfield, gained nice chunks of yardage. But now, in this situation, the field is really condensed, partner. So if he's going to throw the football, that'd be pinpoint here.
Yeah, so I was going to ask you about that. Field shrinks, has to be sharper, but it's been a good opening drive so far.
Now they just want to see if they can cap it off with the bell ringer and put it in the end zone.
They go play action here on first down. Forced out to his left. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. As his guys are in for 6. And the Panthers are now an extra point away from tying up this game. And the QB rating right now, sky high. 4 for 4 on that opening drive, and it ends with a touchdown pass.
Yeah, I don't know quite how to figure it out. I think I need my friends from MIT to come in and help me. But I think 158.3 is the number one.
Yep, that's the
right? That's the highest you can get. That's where he is. He'd like to continue on that pace.
Gano the extra point, and we are tied at 7. The drive summary, 4 plays, 75 yards. And the end result, a Panthers touchdown. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. Out comes a Houston offense as they get set to take over here. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
On first and 10, Watson caught here by Griffin. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. And let's look here at the Houston offense.
come up the lowest yards per carry average of his career is Lamar Miller at 3.7, and that's not normal for him because of his versatility. Can catch it out of the backfield, but his best attribute, high-volume ball carrier. Runs it inside with power, physicality, and some really good vision in order to break some big runs.
Now a first carry for Lamar Miller. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 10 yards there, good enough for a Texan first down.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
They keep it with Miller on first down. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards. And it's second and two.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
Now it's Watson, a bootleg. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. Just a 1 yard pickup on the play. And that is going to set up a 3rd and 1. And the starting defense here for the Panthers.
Spotlight, please, on Shaq Thompson. I always go back to his time at the University of Washington. Played some minor league baseball in the offseason. Could have been a big-time running back. Maybe even a safety, and has settled in as a good, strong outside linebacker in the NFL, whose forte is speed.
They'll try to run for it with Miller, and that play will go nowhere, losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. It'll be a loss of a yard, and it'll be 4th down.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral-type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
The Texans send the punter out as he's on a punt for the first time this afternoon. Now the Panthers offense, they get set to come back onto the field. The last possession, these guys were able to tie the game with a touchdown. Now they'll have a chance to move out in front.
Yeah, let's give a big assist to the defense who got the ball back. The special teams went out there, handled things. They've got it. They've got momentum. I know they're eager to get out there and put it on display.
On 1st and 10, Newton. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. Give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give him a first down.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
So they'll come up 1st and 10 now from the 33. First carry for Christian McCaffrey. And now running right through it. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Usually we see runs like this as the defense breaks down later in the game, but this guy is setting the tone early, running through all types of tackles and put the defense back on its heels.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on 1st down. On 1st down, Newton. Over the middle and into the hands of his receiver, Moore. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff, didn't they?
Yeah, when we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time. Really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
Newton now already over 100 yards passing in just this first quarter. It's 1st and 10. Now a play fake, and it's Newton. And his throw's going to be incomplete. The linebacker, Zach Cunningham, there defensively to make that play. But prior to that, he had hit his first six passes to start the game, so on a nice little run to begin.
It feels like this offense has carried its dress rehearsal into the game, you know, because you do practice it, you do go through it, and in this case, it is clicking exactly like they drew it up.
Back to the air, Newton on second down. And the tight end, Olsen, right side. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. Greg Olsen, 39 yards. And his guys are able to strike for six. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. Gano now to add the extra point. Extra point try good by Gano. And that makes the score 14-7. So that drive spanned five plays. And Carolina scores to cap it off. Zero out now as he'll kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee and they'll start at the 25. Watson will bring up the Texans here first and 10 at their 25-yard line. They'll start out on the ground. It's Lamar Miller. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. First play of the drive going for 14 and also going for a first down. One quarter in the books. 14-7 is the score. The NFL on EA Sports continues right after this message.
The NFL on EA Sports is fueled by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, and it's Texans football as we get going at quarter number two, and they've got it here with a first down. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Watson on first down. He's going to air one out. Oh, incomplete. The rookie had it and lost it there. And it'll be second down.
Fans do love the long ball, don't they? And he already found his guy once. Tried to give him another chance there, didn't he?
Yeah, he did. Couldn't connect. But as you alluded to, he does have that touchdown from earlier, trying to keep him in the rhythm. So line of scrimmage, still the 39 on second and 10. Throwing again on second and 10. Watson setting up the screen for Miller. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. They get 14 on that one. Good for a Houston first down.
As a passer, you're always trying to find that open window to throw the ball downfield. How about this one? Right in the middle of the field, right in the heart of a defense.
So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 47. A shotgun snap for Watson. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Hopkins. Look, DeAndre Hopkins, he's all alone. Touchdown, Houston. DeAndre Hopkins with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Texans are an extra point away from tying this football game. Now he's having a nice little first half here, partner.
And it's a first half that leaves us anticipating what can still come. I mean, two touchdowns already here through the second quarter. There could be plenty more before this game is over.
Fairbairn now to add the extra point. Extra point by Fairbairn, up and good. And we've got a tie game here in a back and forth first half. The drive summary, four plays, 75 yards. And the result, a Houston touchdown. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. This fielded at the two. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Here come the Panthers now, set to take over on offense. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
So Newton and the Panthers come up now first and 10 at their own 26. The drive begins with a run by McCaffrey. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Tackle made by Whitney Mercilus. On second down, McCaffrey. Oh, now he pulls him over. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. And he's able to get most of what he needed on the carry there. 7 yards on the gain. And it's third and two now. They'll try and pick it up with McCaffrey. And he's going to be taken down right at the line. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down. They'll run for it. McCaffrey. And he'll be brought down with the first down and a late flag here, too. And he may get a few more tacked on for good measure.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
Officials so cognizant of that call nowadays, but that one looked pretty easy.
Yeah, you're right. They took out of their hands having to wonder whether it's a 5-yard or a 15-yard inadvertent or not. Now, it's a lot easier. You see it, you call it.
Here's Newton, escaping the pressure right. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. DJ Moore, 46 yards. And the Panthers have broken our tie as they take the lead. So the quarterback drops to throw, looks over, and boom, a guy that wide open. He has to be thinking, wait a minute, this is some kind of a dream. This is too easy.
Yeah, a great dream, one you don't want to wake up from. But for the defense, almost feels like there was a bust in coverage.
Gano for the extra point. Gano the extra point, and the lead is now 21-14. A drive there of just four plays. And the end result, a Panthers touchdown. Captain Zero out now as he'll kick this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. DeAndre Hopkins and the rest of the offense heading back onto the field, making his presence felt early in this one. First half, already over the century mark.
How about the yards per completion, too? That's a pretty darn good number there. Number of catches, but he's shredding defenses, getting big yardage with each and every one of them.
Red 22!
Play action for Miller. Now Watson. Griffin's got it, middle of the field. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A really good pickup of 28 yards.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 47. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
Bart, I remember a coaching friend of mine used to tell his running backs before games, make sure you run and jog with your offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking when those big behemoths start to create space for you up front. He did a pretty good job of just following those guys through there for a nice explosive run.
On second down, here's Miller. Trying to bounce it outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. In on the tackle there, Luke Kuechly.
He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose the run and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
On third down, Miller. Quick move by Miller. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been four down territory if they didn't pick it up, but...
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, so if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah, we didn't have to make that call, but I have a feeling both of us would have said, go for it.
The Texans with a first opportunity now from the red zone. They've got a first and goal from the 10-yard line.
Hey, who waiting? Who waiting?
They'll try the air now with Watson. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12. That'll set them back with a loss of 3 on the play. And that'll make it second and goal.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. They'll try again on second and goal after going backwards to the 12. Watson. This will be caught just inside the 10. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. They'll wind up getting 7 on the completion, but they'll still be faced now with a third and goal situation. A reminder coming up here at halftime, we'll ship you off to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman will have first half highlights and analysis from a back and forth first half that we've seen.
Hey, who waiting? Who waiting?
Now Watson on third and goal. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the 6. It'll be a loss of 1, and that'll bring up 4th down. All right, so the timeout over and all 11 men back out onto the field for the defense. Fairbairn able to put this one through. And that'll bring him back within 4. That drive took him inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold him to 3.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made them kick the field goal. And yeah, points went against them, but that feels a whole lot better running off the field.
Fairbairn now following the made field goal. He'll send this one away. On the return, it's Kenyon Barner. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Cam Newton getting ready to go again on offense. And how about the start so far, Charles? 3 first-half touchdown passes.
And that's how you generate excitement on a team. Keep your offense moving at a really high level. And it's also how you establish leadership, by playing that well. 3 touchdown passes, that's the way to lead.
Now he's just hoping for number 4. Olsen too much. And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football. A good pickup there, a 22.
Sometimes it's designed, and sometimes you just have to know when to leave the pocket and move and make something happen. And on that play, he was able to get on the run and was still accurate throwing the football.
So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. Now Newton on first down. Flush to his right. And incomplete there, almost picked off. That's one you maybe expect your roaming free safety to come up with. But it's second down.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. To throw again. Newton eluding the pressure right. And this one complete right side to Funchess. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. Play action. It's Newton. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. He couldn't get the hook up there that time with Thomas, and it's second down.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. Second and 10, Newton again. Being chased out left. Quick slant, caught by Moore. A really nice gain of 25 yards. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
A chance to really cap off a big first half here as they come up on first and goal. To the air again, Newton. And nearly picked off. Surprising to see a defender of his caliber let it get away, but it does get away and it's second down.
Quarterbacking 101. Never force the ball into double coverage. Especially not this close to the goal line. The windows are so tight, you just don't want to force it in there because it could be tipped up and picked off.
Nothing on first down, so the ball remains at the 8-yard line, second and goal. He'll get it up the middle. Showed off the toughness, but still corralled shy of the 5 at the 6. Only a couple yards there, and that's going to set up a long third and goal. Newton now to throw. And that's going to be caught by Funchess for a Carolina touchdown. 4 touchdown passes now for Cam Newton. And the Panthers add on to their lead. And that'll give them a 2-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here of the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
Gano now to add the extra point. Extra point try good by Gano. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. So that drive takes them down the field in eight plays. And Carolina scores to cap it off. Zero out now as he'll kick this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And a look now at Lamar Miller. He's been good. They've utilized him well, but they're losing here in the second quarter. What might they change offensively?
I think that what you try and do is expand how you get the ball to him a little bit. Get him out in open space, maybe swing the ball to him. What's that they used to call it in the West Coast offense, the long handoff?
Yeah.
Serve as your running play that way, as well as continue to feed him the football. Some of these runs now may pop bigger later in the game because of the effects of running it. Sometimes people, after a while, they don't want to tackle him anymore, or they get tired, or they get out of position, or he runs through tackles. Continue to feed him the ball. He's having that kind of game.
Yeah, might they get him the ball in some space in some different ways here? Line of scrimmage, again the 25, second and 10. On second and 10, Watson. Oh, a battle for it here, and this will be caught. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead, as the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number two. On first down, Watson. Now they go screen. It's complete. Now the Texans will use one of their two remaining timeouts as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this first half. So they had the big loss on that first down pass play and facing a second and long. To the air yet again, Watson. And he'll find QT on the right side complete. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. Cool under pressure right there, escaping the pocket and finding what I think was not his primary target.
And some of these guys are just so comfortable getting outside of the pocket that they'll do it on purpose. It doesn't even need to be a breakdown. They move, and they know it affects the defense because a lot of times you get lost in coverage in the secondary. And I think you're exactly right. Wasn't his primary target. Found a secondary guy who sprang open, probably because of his movement out of the pocket.
Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down. And they're going to take a timeout defensively. So with fourth down coming up, they go ahead and burn it and say, we'll see what happens. The defense, they got a little bit of a breather. Now they're back and set as we resume play. The Texans send the punter out as he'll kick it away for the second time. Likely time for one final snap as they start out first and 10. A final shot before the break. Newton. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. So we come upon halftime. Intermission here with the visiting Panthers taking the lead to the locker room. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach.
In our game, it was Cam Newton who led the way in that first half. He's thrown for over 200 yards already, and his guys have the lead as well. As we get you back to Brandon Godden.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Panthers out in front, and they will get the football first. Second half action underway. This is fielded at the goal line. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. There's DJ Moore as he and the rest of the offense head back out there. Good day for him so far here in the third quarter. He's hit pay dirt once, over 100 yards, but hey, it's the third quarter. He's thinking, I want more, right?
He wants more, and it just increases the confidence of his team because every play he makes, that means his quarterback is really feeling good about throwing the football. Probably feels like he can't throw an incomplete pass when he throws it to him right now.
Yeah, he's looked really, really sharp. Now a play fake here on first down. Flushed out right. The attempt on the dive, and he has it. What a catch. First down yardage on the first play of the drive. Give him 14.
And that's how you throw for a whole heap of yards in a game. You get efforts like that from your receivers. How about him laying out for that catch?
Yeah, excellent. Makes the quarterback look a whole lot better. They go play action here on first down. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Different pass rushes are designed for different things. Sometimes you want to keep the quarterback in the pocket. Sometimes you want him to flush. I don't know exactly how this one was designed, but they made sure they moved him to his right. He got out of the pocket. Unfortunately for him, he was hit as he tried to throw the ball, and that resulted in an incompletion.
On second and 10, Newton buying time to his left. Looking left side, that's caught by Moore. A big play there for the Panthers. And even 40 yards.
On any given pass play, you never know exactly where your exit points are going to be. On this play, he was flushed to his left, still on the run, able to accurately throw the football for a nice first down.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. From the red zone now, Newton. And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football, and he's taken down. Jadeveon Clowney in there to get him his second sack now of the afternoon.
I know there'll be a little bit of criticism there because they went right back to the air after the huge pickup and end up getting sacked. But that's often a play that you make. You feel like you've got momentum on your side.
Unfortunately, the O-line failed to hold up to try to keep that momentum going. Now following the sack, they'll look to make amends on a second down and 17. From the gun, here's Newton, escaping the pressure right, and it's incomplete, broken up, but there is a flag down. Let's see what that's about.
Pass interference, defense.
So the contact came before the ball got there, and the flag is thrown.
Timing is everything, isn't it? And it's so hard to cover these great receivers. They have such great body control, and they can fake you out. In this case, as you described, got there before the ball got to the receiver. Penalty flag had to come out.
And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. It'll be a pickup of 5 on the keeper. It's second down.
Third quarter, and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Here's Newton now on second down. And he will score. Touchdown, Panthers. Cam Newton taking it in. And the Panthers are able to grow their lead.
That drive that really increased their cushion felt very military to me. Very precise, methodical. That's one of the words you've taught me. And they just got it done.
And slowly but surely now starting to pull away a little bit. Things looking good for them here in the third quarter.
Not only pulling away, but you mentioned that slowly but surely. You also drain clock, too, with a drive like that. So you really give yourself an advantage.
Got Gano the extra point, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. So the drive there took six plays, and Cam able to take it himself in for the score. Catanzaro out now as he'll kick this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Getting set to go again, DeAndre Hopkins marches back onto the field. And I know that they've double-teamed him a couple times, but not a ton. Whatever they're doing isn't working. He's up over 100 yards. We'll see how they adjust.
And when they do that, they weaken their defense in other places as well. And how many times have we done games where we've seen a guy have a big game like this? But it's usually not by himself, is it? Usually it opens it up for other people to have big games as well.
They begin with a run by Miller. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level, because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat? And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is at well over 300 pounds. He's a big man. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. They get 14 on that one. Good for a Houston first down.
It looks way too easy right now. Two carries, two straight first down runs. The eyes are carrying the legs to the proper hole, but they're being created by an offensive line that has the leverage game going for them right now. Lower than the defensive front, creating space, and he's finding it in a big way. Gotta love what they're doing on offense right now.
He'll get about three as he's brought down right around the 42.
What's the old expression, 3 yards in a cloud of dust? In this case, it's dust-covered pellets. It's no longer that old grass that we used to play on, right, and chew it up. Now we've got that artificial surface. You see the pellets go up. Still a nice play by the defense.
Back to throw, Watson, caught, left side, Hopkins. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that's going to bring up a third down. And never good on a pass completion there to go the wrong way, lost yardage.
No, for some reason it seems to work better when you throw it downfield or you can move the ball downfield running it that way, doesn't it? But in this case, if you're the defensive guys, you're energized, executed well, and you caused a lost yardage play. That's going to feel good and look great in film.
Green the line!
Throwing on third down, Watson. And this is going to be incomplete.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
The Texans send the punter out as he's on to kick it away. He's going to field this at the four. A good return there, 17 yards. And the Panthers will take over now, first and 10. Carolina getting set to take the field. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
They'll try to get the running game going with McCaffrey. And now running right through him. Oh, and now he bowls him over. And he'll take it ahead to the 28-yard line. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three. They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again. Shifts by him. They'll only get a couple up to about the 30. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Third down, here's McCaffrey. And he's able to get it to the 33, good enough for a first down. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving.
That's a tremendous group effort there, because when you talk about offensive lines, the best ones, talk about guys that play in harmony, in sync, and getting things done, and they did that on that play.
Yeah, especially on third and one, got to be in sync, and they were. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Newton on first down. And the tight end, Olsen, right side. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one, and that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league. Those guys who can run, make plays after the catch, and gain that additional yardage.
And using that speed there to turn it into a pretty nice little gain. Going to run the option right. A little juke. Oh, and now some space to operate. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first.
Well, partner, for a few years there, we thought this read option play was going to take over the whole NFL. It seemed like everyone was using it, but it has been scaled back considerably in the last few seasons, mainly because people worried about their quarterbacks getting hit. But when you call it the right time and you use it properly, you see the type of gains you can get. A nice chunk of yardage there by the quarterback.
On first and 10, Newton. Oh, he got position on him, and he pulls it in. Three quarters have come and gone. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now in Houston. It's the Panthers out in front and in control of the football as well as we begin quarter number four. Newton now, five straight completions here in this second half, first and 10. Newton to throw. Steps away to his left. And that'll be incomplete. Greg Olsen was the intended target, and that'll bring up second down. And not to get too overcritical there because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right. That pass will go from incomplete to complete.
Back to the air, Newton on second down. That is caught at the 7. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. Fifth catch of the afternoon, and that gives him a first down. Still throwing the football here, even with the big lead.
Yeah, I know you and I came up in a different era, and we think about sportsmanship and all that. Other people think about fantasy points and getting their numbers. That's all they care about right now.
Three red zone trips, three touchdowns so far. They'll look for a fourth on second and goal. They'll try to run with McCaffrey. And he'll be stopped about a yard shy of the goal line after a pickup of about 3. Second and goal from the 1. On the ground, McCaffrey. And he's not going to push his way forward. He's going to be stopped at the 2-yard line. They hold him again, and now all of a sudden, it's third and goal at the 1. McCaffrey. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. He lost 2, and it brings up 4th. Here we go with McCaffrey. And he'll be caught behind the line of scrimmage at the 3. McCaffrey turned away on 4th and goal. And his Texans defense comes up with a goal line stand. So they were really trying to put the nail in the coffin there already with this lead here in the 4th. But they didn't get it.
Guaranteed.
it's not going to be a fun handshake in the postgame, right? You just know that there's going to be some bad blood there. And I know if we go to the postgame press conferences, the winning coach, you know what he's going to say, why he did it? We need the points, okay? Because you never know at the end of the year if points are going to come into the tiebreaker if we're trying to get into the playoffs. That's always the standard justification.
The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down.
Down! Flat 22!
A first down carry now for Miller. And I don't know if he made it out of the end zone. No signal. Yes, it's a safety. And Charles, at some point, you can't keep worrying about big play. Can this be perfect? You just have to get the ball out of the end zone.
And in the offensive huddle, that was discussed when they called the play. Just get out of the end zone. But you know what's interesting? A lot of the times in the defensive huddle, they actually call a set and then say at the end of it, get a safety. So it's preached, it's coached, it's thought about.
Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. And last time, they had it fourth and goal, rolled the dice, didn't get it. Now they've got to put that behind them, try to put together another drive.
Hey, a simple tip of the cap, a nod of the head to the defense. Congratulations, you got us last time. But you didn't hold us the whole time. We got down to position. We were able to be in position to score. Let's go ahead and attack again. Continue to have that kind of confidence. Not worry about the one play that didn't allow them to get into the end zone.
And this time they'll be trying to get it into the end zone. We'll see what they do.
Where Brandon Pace comes into play now because they've got the advantage. They've got the football. But they've got to be very careful about what speed they're going to play. You know, my music teacher back in New Paltz, this is by Thema Bagley.
And got his man complete. A fantastic connection that time. Newton to Funchess, 41 yards. They have the nice cushion. They just want to pour it on right now, still throwing the football.
And I know my background says, why do you need to do this? Just go ahead and run out the clock and get a win. But as many people have pointed out to me, this is a video game, man. Go ahead and put the numbers up. Sportsmanship, not an issue.
Exercise those fingers. To throw is Newton. Flush to his right. Oh, he's able to outmuscle him here as he pulls it in. A good pickup there, a 22.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down, stomp down. How about that? Back-to-back completions, they are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Newton going to hand it off to McCaffrey. And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be second and goal.
Well, it's been the air game that's taken them down on this drive before they finally turned around and handed it off on the last play.
And now they're looking for the big boys to get him in the end zone. Couldn't do it there.
It'll be interesting to see. Offensive lines had to pass block a lot on this drive. Will they be able to revert and fire out and create some space in the run game?
They'll give it to him up the middle. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that is going to set up third and goal.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway.
Ready.
He can run for it, and he will. And he's going to ball his way in for a Panther score. Cam Newton keeping it himself from 8 yards out. And the Panthers add on to their lead.
Go, go, go. Run, run, run. Touchdown. Touchdown, baby. Yeah, good job, O. That's the way to make it spin, baby. That's the way to make it spin.
Still an important piece of business to take care of, the extra point. Extra point try good by Gano. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. A drive that time of six plays. And Cam able to take it himself in for the score. Zero out now as he'll kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee and they'll start at the 25. DeAndre Hopkins and the rest of the offense heading back onto the field. When you're in a zone like he is, what's the conversation like on the sideline between he and his quarterback? Is that a one-way conversation of, hey, just keep getting me the football?
It actually is probably a two-way conversation because he wants to keep getting him the football because he's seeing the payoff. You know, getting the ball to that guy means yardage and, as we've seen, touchdowns in this game. So I think both of them get more and more excited about the possibilities as things continue on.
Yeah, so far it's been over 100 yards and the two scores. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. You got the big lead defensively, willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Black 22!
On second down, here's Watson. And this one complete to Will Fuller. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 11 yards there as they connect on the quick slant.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10.
Down! Black 22!
On first down, it's Watson. Trying to get it to Thomas, and it's intercepted. Picked up by James Bradbury. Thomas, the intended target. This spot in the fourth quarter with that deficit, had to throw the football. Unfortunately, there's the risk of big turnover.
And you know you're going to be throwing against nickel, dime, all sorts of exotic defenses, but you have to do it anyway. Ordinarily, you might want to run the football a little bit, try and get them out of it. But as you noted, this time of the game, this point on the clock, had to throw it.
The Panthers offense here, they get ready to head back on the field. They come into enemy territory, and I don't care what the matchup is in the National Football League, you're up like this late in the game on the road. This feels pretty good.
Oh, it feels fantastic. Anytime you get a road victory in the NFL, that's a big-time accomplishment, and to do it this convincingly, that just tears up the script that every home team has, which is nobody comes into our house.
And this is caught inside the five. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the 5. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Back at the 5-yard line now, second and goal. He'll get it up the middle. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. He lost 4 there, and it's third down. Again, they run. Again, it's McCaffrey. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. A gain of 7 might change the thought process here as they have some options on fourth and goal. They'll give it up to McCaffrey, and they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals.
I tell you, Charles, you play to the final whistle, I get that, but there are a few folks that might not be too happy with that score late in the game with it already well in hand.
You seem a little squeamish about that last score.
I struggle with this one. I struggle. But on the other, the argument, I get it, on the other side is, hey, do something about it. Stop them.
I guarantee you, I know who was really excited. Fantasy owners who had them. Hey, listen, get the points for me. They're not worried about hurt feelings or anything like that. That's just new age stuff.
Gano the extra point, and the lead will swell by one more. The drive summary that time, five plays. And the last play on the drive, the touchdown run from Christian McCaffrey. Captain Zero out now as he'll kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25.
Down! Black 22! Black!
One last throw here for Watson. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Mike Adams. And his guys are going to take over at their own 48-yard line. Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. So long from Houston.
Yeah.